Welcome back to Aline's Creative Living. Coming up in this half hour, more great ideas, like a pot of gold LaPouf style, a Noah's Ark touch, and ceramic arches from ProCrafts. But first, in today's second time around, we take you back to November when Kathy joined Vesta Abel from Commotion to craft up a storm with a fun and durable new product. It's almost leather.
Thanks, Tiffany. Hello, Vesta. Welcome back.
Thank you, Kathy. I'm glad to be back.
And today you've brought us something called Almost Leather. And I'm amazed that it's not leather.
I know.
This picture frame is incredible. I love the Western look, and with the leather attitude, it's just had such a great touch.
Oh, it's just so much fun. I can't wait to show you how it looks and works.
And when I picked up one of these hair barrettes, I was amazed to see how lightweight it was.
Mm-hmm. And very durable. It's more durable than leather because you don't have to worry about it getting wet or...
This photo album is one of my favorites. The way that you've tweaked the almost leather and just adds again to that leather touch. Mm-hmm. And the burnished edge. Now you've added some extra little jewels there. And you're telling me the design was created with a rubber stamp?
Right. The little design that's on the front of that, I've just stamped it on while the foam is hot, and it gives it dimension like that.
Now you call it foam, but it's almost leather.
But it's almost leather.
And I know you kept calling it that, and until I touched it, I couldn't believe it. So I'm anxious to see how to do this great technique.
Okay, we'll get started. One of the things we do a lot, you'll notice that we've added pieces onto things, and today we're gonna use this little box. And these little boxes are so popular these days, and all you would do is take the lid, and if you want it to be a perfect fit, you just go around it like that, and see how you'll have that on there? And this one piece here, you can put about three of them and also get some of the hair barrettes out of it as well.
And you can draw right onto
it. Draw right onto it, and you can use these decorative scissors with it. Look at how easily it cuts it.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Go around.
So you have a variety of edges to choose
from. Exactly. And so I've already got a piece here that we're gonna use. And then you use your heat tool with it.
Now, I want to show the viewers real quick that the piece fits exactly on the top of this box.
Yes, right now it just goes right to the edge of that, which would be a little bit too big. But because when it goes through this heating process, it shrinks slightly. I don't know exactly how much, but it's not like shrink plastic or anything like that, but I mean, it does shrink slightly. See how it's starting to puff up a little bit?
I see a difference in it.
Okay.
So you just go over both sides with the heat tool.
To make it so that it's even all over, you want to just heat it like that.
And about how long do you need to heat this?
I would say 30 to 40 seconds. If you don't want the piece to shrink a little bit, I would say it's ready to stamp in about 20 seconds.
Now, these are wonderful pieces for boutiques. I know that Commotion has great rubber stamps, and our viewers are often worried about using the rubber stamps for items they're going to sell.
Well, we want people to use them for that purpose, and we think it's great for people to earn money off of these items that they produce and sell. And as long as they're hand stamping whatever it is they're working on, it's fine to do that. Now, I'm using the permanent ink, which also comes in the kit like that. And then you just press it down into this while that's still hot.
And Vesta, you had pre-inked this.
Now,
that's great. Look at the dimension.
It looks like hand tooling, and that's all you've done to it. That's as easy as could be, and it really looks like hand tooled leather. Now, I go back after you're through putting your design there. I'm taking a sponge, and I'm just taking this ink, and I'm going to do the edge.
See, and this really gives it the burnished leather look.
And see how a little bit of it gets onto the front? And it finishes the piece off like that. And you would continue to do that all the way around, and it gives it more of the aged leather look.
And then I want to show the viewers now how the piece has shrunken a little.
Yes, it's shrunken a little bit here. Now, I didn't go as long as you normally would, but you'll see on our finished box over here that we have put on, it creates a little frame for it.
Yeah, it's a great
look.
And
see, that's a perfect fit in there right now.
And you can apply the almost leather to several different surfaces. These are mache boxes.
Exactly.
And you've applied it to fabric and the photo album.
I've put it on baskets. You know, this you can use it as a piece by itself for leather jewelry, for You know, the hair barrettes, like I said, too.
Can you tell me quickly what comes in the Get Acquainted kit?
Yes, we have a package that has the almost leather in it, 3 sheets of the lighter tan, and then 1 sheet of the dark, and the catalog, the permanent ink, and the cat stamp.
This is another wonderful technique. Thank you for sharing it today.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Back to you, Tiffany.
If you would like to write for free instructions, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to S421. Commotion Almost Leather. If you would like to order the Commotion Almost Leather Get Acquainted Kit number 116962 for $24.25 plus shipping and handling, call 1-800-825-3363. Coming up next, a pot of gold from LePouf. Stay tuned.
Let your creative idea